I rise to ask question 89-2017 under my name and is directed to Minister for Defence and National Security. Can the Minister advise this House on what the Republic of Fiji military forces is currently doing in the expansion of its role to increase its participation in nation building? Thank you.
Thank you, Honourable Minister.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'd like to first of all thank the Honourable Alvin Maraj for his question. Madam Speaker, just for the information of, before I go on to answer the question, for the information of the House, as of today, the Republic of Fiji Military Forces, they have 2,860 in the regular force and 4,279 in the territorial force. Madam Speaker, the Republic of Fiji Military Forces has grown over the years from purely a military-oriented dominant force before and during independence. It has enhanced in size and strength over the years to effectively carry out its core role as detailed in the Constitution, the 2013 Constitution. The RFMF, apart from peacekeeping operations, has developed into a useful government asset that has been deployed frequently by government to engage in nation building and national development. Madam Speaker, in its efforts to enhance the education system, the RFMF Engineers Corps has assisted in constructing schools in areas where such assistance is greatly needed and has been neglected for such a long time. These developments have provided those in the rural areas equal opportunity and access to infrastructure similar to those in the urban areas of Fiji. The RFMF still undertakes training in underprivileged youths in trade skills such as carpentry and construction in its trade training school. In instilling discipline to the youths of the country, the RFMF also provides training assistance and support to cadet training programs in secondary schools throughout Fiji. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you. Honourable William Nawoka.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Honourable Speaker, as we travel across around the country, we see that infrastructure will take 50 years, if not more, to bring into the standard that we all want: roads, seaports, bridges, drainage, and all that. I just wonder if the RFMF can be engaged in a bigger way with infrastructure, i.e., out of these regular forces, if a major part of that can become the engineering corps and help with the infrastructure development. Thank you.
Honourable Minister.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Thank you for. I'd like to thank you. Thank the Honourable Member for the supplementary question. I'm sure we can look at that. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you, Honourable Senator Karawaki.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. In relation to the activities that have been explained by the Honourable Minister, can the Minister please explain how those activities relate to the constitutional role of the RFMF? Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you, Honourable Minister.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'd like to thank the Honourable Leonard Member for his supplementary question. As I mentioned in my reply to this question, the RFMF has grown over the years from a purely military-oriented dominant force before and during independence. As you know, we use our soldiers for disaster response and other ways of developments in Fiji. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you. Honourable Roki Roki.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. We acknowledge the remittances that is remitted to Fiji in terms of the salaries of peacekeepers. My question is there any rehabilitation program, counseling,
when the forces, the men, returned to Fiji, because when they assimilate to the civil society, that can alleviate a lot of social problems, like we know other nations, they go to drugs, violence, violence against women, children, their absence from home. Is there any rehabilitation program conducted by RFMF for the soldiers when they come back? Thank you.
Thank you, Honourable Minister.
Thank you, Honourable. Thank you, Madam Speaker. I thank the Honourable Member for that supplementary question. Just a very short, quick answer, Madam Speaker. The military forces, they have a party, a chaplain, full-time chaplain, that does this work in counselling our soldiers. Thank you.